Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. In this video, I'm going to show you my emergency preparedness binder. A few years ago, I put together this binder because I found this 8-week course online from abowlfulloflemons.net. I'll put a link to her website below for this particular 8-week course. And from there, I've just added to the binder. So you definitely need to have a binder. This is a Staples Better binder. It's pretty strong. It is the 1.5-inch one. I used the color red and I used a lot of labels from my label maker. This is the one that I have. It's a P-Touch by Brother. I've had this for over a decade. It's never broken. So it's really very reliable. When you open it up, it looks like this. Now you could definitely put a pencil bag in here, but I don't really need it because there's not a lot of stuff that I'm going to write in here. Usually when you're done with the 8-week course, everything is filled up, but in this video, I'm showing you all the blank pages because there's important information, so I don't want to show it on video. If you don't have a pencil bag, you can go ahead and just put a pen and pencil here for things you have to write or cross off. And I highly suggest to use a pencil at first because you will definitely be changing things up, especially for your 72-hour emergency kit. Here, I've just put an example. If you use your label maker or any type of name tag, go ahead and put your name and number in case this binder is found. For whatever reason, it can hopefully be returned to you. So following this, it says to make a plan, build a kit, and be informed. So this binder is all about that, the plan, the information, and how to build a kit. Now, what I've always liked is up here, instead of using those tabs on the side because you can never see them, and even when you fill it up, you can't see the tags. You're gonna be flipping through them. So here is a tab. You know those tabs? They come in 5 or 8 or even the whole alphabet. And it has this part here and it never sticks out. So you still have to flip through it. So I just use this as a divider. I use the label maker. So I like to use these tabs that are kind of like post-it notes, but definitely it's stickier, it stays on. That when you're looking at the top of your binder, you can see all the categories. And then you can, example, go to, let's say, first aid here. I go to that tab, lay it down, and it opens directly to that spot. I'll put links to any of these items on Amazon. Definitely you can go and try the office stores like Staples and Office Depot and Office Max or whatever is near you. Now, since this is happening right now, I went ahead and put a category for that. I put dividers in here like this that have a pocket that you can put pamphlets or other information in here, whether it's temporary or more permanent. And then as you see, I put that tab here and it just sticks on there. I use my label maker and I've just printed out stuff from the CDC website and the other websites for information. And I stuck them into these sheet protectors. So here's some of the stuff that you might be interested in printing out. Now, of course, you can always go online and read these. What I like is to have just the funneled information that I feel like I need to reference and put it in the binder instead of looking it up each time on the internet. And then here is another category, germs and flu. Here's a fun one I wanted to print out for you. If you have younger kids, this is a great resource to have printed out and you can go over it with them. Here's some basic information on how to wash your hands and keeping water safe, which is we're very particular about that right now. So the next section is for stuff that is particular to the area that I live in. I live in Arizona, so we don't normally have tornadoes or hurricanes in the desert or earthquakes, right? So always knock on wood, but what we do have are dust storms, floods. Can you imagine floods in the desert? At first, when my husband opened up his business, they're like, you need flood insurance, it's in a flood zone. And I'm like, it floods in the desert? Yes, it sure does, now I know that. So flood information, fire information, no matter where you live, apartment, condo, even if you live in a van and there's a fire, right? Like you need to know your plan for evacuation and your plan for after the fire, what you and your family are going to do, and then power outage. Now, power outage is the, for me, like probably the number one thing I'm concerned about. I've been caught in a dust storm on the freeway on the I-10 with semi trucks. I mean, that's pretty scary. And so I need information for that. So I've just left it blank because it's, I need to fill this up a little bit more, and then there's some personal information I need. For example, the fire and the flood example, you would put like a map of your area or your home where you would meet in case of a fire, and it's divided that way. I have here a tab divider. I put the label here and the label there. This was from the UPS store. It was probably like $2 or something, and they have different things like history and the presidents and geography. So I found this one for first aid and I thought it was perfect. The holes were already in it, so it's meant to be used, let's say, for an office, information for your office. So I thought this was like absolutely perfect, and it folds and fits into the binder. So this is what is referred to here as another emergency binder that is with our documents. So I decided to have it in an envelope versus another binder, because my idea in an emergency is that I can grab this binder if need be, but if it's too heavy and I just need something even lighter, the most important thing that I need are the documents. So this is, I wanted to show you, I just put this on a divider here just to show you what it is, but it's an Oxford 10058 if you're interested in this type of envelope. Okay, Oxford. I think it's really fun. It has, it's specifically for a binder. It has this enclosure here for 8.5 by 11 size papers. And then it has this smaller envelope here for smaller papers. And then it has a label here. So these are docs to go, documents to go. And I've used my label maker again to just list out the things that are in here, right? And so I always say, list it out, label it. It takes out one extra step for you to think, especially in a stressful situation. Now I have two types of envelopes here. I have the smaller one for me, and this one is for my family. And here I just used a sticker with a dollar sign because this is where we're going to have cash, okay? So the suggestion is to have $100 per person. You could put it here, you could put it in their bags, which are called bug out bags, bags you take with you. So I have it here, and then I have it in their bags. So I can grab these three with me, if my family is with me or not. If my family is with me, I know that this is separated for them, so it just helps me think of making sure that each person is set up. And then within this poly envelope are separate envelopes, so you can just write on there the name, and then you could put the amount of money if you want, or you may not want to advertise it. So that's my binder. I hope you enjoyed this video of my emergency preparedness binder. Let me know in the comments below what you would put as a category in your binder, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought. Pride.